In competitive programming, there are mainly two types of competitions. Some small online contests, rounds, something like a league in football or esports, and also big on-site competitions. Then you fly to some place, sometimes in USA or China, Europe, different places around the world, and you compete against another around 20 people who also got to the finals. Then often there are some big cash prizes of around up to $20,000. It's not crazy money, but it's still nice. Let's start with overview of online platforms, online rounds that happen regularly every few days. And the main websites you should know are codeforces.com, adcoder.jp, topcoder, codechef, hackerf, and hackerrank. All of these regularly hold contests once every week, let's say, but in total, if you combine that, you will have a competition once every 2 days, and you can participate from your home. Every platform keeps some rating of every participant, every person registered, and it works very similar to ELO in chess, where if you win or if you participate better than your rating suggests, you go up, otherwise you go down. Of course, in chess, it's 1v1. Here, it's thousands or hundreds of participants solving problems at the same time, and they are ranked first by points scored, by problems solved correctly. Harder problems usually give you more points. And then in case of ties, by total time it took you to solve the problems. At the end of this video, I will show you how the beginning of such a contest looks like, and I will talk more about virtual participation, an ability to participate in some old online contests and see how the leaderboard would look like after, let's say, first 5 minutes of the contest. You can kind of simulate the contest much later, and this way you can practice without losing your rating. You can kind of test your skills before trying for real and risking your rating. Stop, change of plans. This video turned out to be too long, so I decided to cut out the ending part about virtual participation, and I will cover it some other time. Instead, you had this quick times 10 speed recording of the virtual participation. Sorry about that. Platforms I already mentioned, they hold quite standard contests where you're given a few problems and you need to solve them. For each of them, there is some correct solution. You need to come up with one or something equivalent, not less efficient. But there are also some less usual platforms like Project Euler with math problems. There's also codinggame.com with AI bot game competitions where you need to implement a bot and it will play some game, some simple game described in the problem statement. Actually, in 2 days from now, I will stream on Twitch, twitch.tv/Errichto, my participation in one such problem. If you want to see how this looks like, then you can tune in. Finally, there are some approximation, optimization, and sometimes machine learning contests on kaggle.com and topcoder.com, marathon category or long contests category. And there you're given a very long problem. You have like a week or a month to solve it. And you need to solve it as well as you can. Sometimes those problems will be from real world and with huge prizes, like detecting pollution in oceans or detecting cancer from some reading, health reading from a patient. As long as your performance can be measured, for example, we have some data of patients with cancer and without cancer, and you're asked to write a program that will detect for each of them how likely do you think that person has a cancer, then if your performance can be measured, how good your program is, then there can be a competition out of that. But for example, it's harder to make a competition of some front end on or creating a website where it's about functionality and making it nice and pretty. This is harder to judge. In particular, all those contests I mentioned, they are judged automatically. It's not that somebody will read your code. Your code can be very ugly, but it's only important that it's correct and efficient. Everybody wants to perform good in those online contests. And if you achieve that, you feel satisfied and happy. If you don't, then you will be frustrated or sad. But it's nothing compared to on-site competitions. There are those like Google CodeGem, Topcoder Open, Facebook HackerCup with online eliminations. And then around 20, from 8 to 25 people are invited to the finals. Your flight is covered. You will get nice hotel. Sometimes it's 5-star hotel. I was in such hotels a few times in my life, only thanks to competitions. And then it's real stress because you feel pressure of time. There is around 3 hours. Usually they are longer than online contests, but it's much harder. There are sometimes cameras. you hear and see other people participating and typing their keyboards on their keyboards. It's a real on-site contest. Some less standard contests are distributed code jam. It was held a few times in the past. It was about writing parallel algorithms and Google Hashcode, one of optimization contests where you need to solve problem as well as you can. There isn't just some binary solution that will solve it optimally. You can keep improving, but it's an NP-hard problem most of the time. Nobody will invent a fast enough algorithm that will get the best solution. By the way, example of that would be traveling salesman problem, TSP, where given a bunch of cities, you need to find the shortest path that visits all of them. Nobody knows polynomial solution for that, but you can keep improving some slow solution so it would find better and better answers. Whoever will get the best total distance through all N cities, they win. And while all those contests were for everybody, you can be a student, you can be a professional, and you can participate, they are open. There are also two very big competitions for high school and for universities. For high school, it's IOI, International Olympiad in Informatics. It's huge, many people try to get there, participate, and it's really prestigious to advance to the finals and to get medals there. Medals aren't just for top three people, they are for some number of people in the top. Like top 20 will get gold medals, but of course there is one winner, and I wish I won such a competition. I started quite late with programming, so I couldn't get to IOI finals. I don't claim that I would win, but for sure I would fight for the medals. And there is ICPC for university students. It's also huge, so many people participating, but it's a team competition. It's a competition for teams of three from the same university, and you have just one computer. 5 hours, around 12 problems, 3 people, 1 computer, and you need to share this resource efficiently. Cooperate, sometimes solve problems separately, but for harder problems it's about cooperation. And I loved participating in those contests, like ICPC and qualifications for that, trainings for that, some other smaller competitions, because it's very fun and I can focus on problems I like best, like my category. That would be maybe math, ad hoc, computational geometry, combinatorics, while my other two teammates are specialized in something else. Then really each of us can excel in something particular, not just be well-rounded. I was lucky enough to get to finals of all contests I mentioned, other than IOI for high schools, and I met so many interesting and smart people. I traveled the world, won some money, and had so much fun. This is, I guess, some high-end goal in competitive programming. If you want to practice it for many, many years and want to become one of the best, then you will finally attend a lot of those on-site competitions. But it's not just for the very best. There are some local competitions, maybe in your city, maybe in your country or region, like Central Europe, and you can go to those. You will end up with a lot of t-shirts, with a lot of badges from competitions, maybe with some trophies, with some medals. I think greatest achievement is second place in Google Code Jam 2018. And it was lucky. I'm not the second best person in the world. I was just lucky. There is some variance in each of those competitions. Sometimes I would be the last in the finals. I think 25th or 24th among 24 people in at least one Facebook Hacker Cup. But hey, this happens. Google Code Jam 2020 qualification round starts in around a week, I think in several days. So check that out and participate. The first rounds are quite easy and you have a lot of time to solve some number of problems. Then the later the round, I think there are around 4 rounds in total online. And each next round is harder and fewer people will advance to the next one. But hey, you can start. Your goal can be get to round number 2 or get to round number 3. This is, by the way, a t-shirt from Code Jam, and I got in my life maybe 200 t-shirts I needed to throw most of them away. So I just kept some. This is the back. Apparently it was from Toronto or Toronto, I don't know. But before you get to all those on-site competitions and get to travel the world for free, it's nice to start with a lot of problems online and contests online. One of them would be codeforces.com, one of such platforms where you can practice. Go to codeforces.com, tap contests, choose any past contest, best it should be Division 3 or Educational for Starters. Choose time when you want to start, and then there will be some countdown. Finally, I recommend website clist.by. It's a list of coming and ongoing contests, a lot of them including online and on-site competitions. Here I see that in one day there will be some random contest on hackerearth.com and on couchchef.com, but I don't have that much time nowadays and I only participate in Codeforces and AdCoder. And for you, if you start, the best ones will be Codeforces Division 3 and 2 and educational contests and AdCoder beginner contests. Other platforms also have some easy contests, and in some platforms you will see on the main page some description of what each contest is about. Whether it's for university students, everybody, it's easy or hard, or maybe some other information like prizes. I hope you learned something from this video. If yes, consider subscribing, like in the video, turning on notification, that bell button or something like that. I don't know what else. Share with your friends. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.